welcome to Restorative Yoga. I'm Vanessa, and I am deeply excited that you have decided to take some time and energy to honor your body today with some stillness. We're going to go ahead and start today with a little bit of gratitude and grounding in our bodies. The beautiful thing about yoga is it is the connection of movement and breath, and bringing those two things together. So that's what we're gonna focus on today, bringing a little bit of stillness and calm into our body as we move through things really slowly and gently. Now, remember, you are your own yoga teacher. You know your body better than anyone else. So if anything feels unsettling or doesn't sit right with your body, shift and find what feels good. This is all about nourishing yourself and your body. So do what feels right and listen to that little voice inside that's telling you when to move forward, when to slow down, and when to stop. Restorative yoga is a very passive practice, so there's going to be a lot of options with props to help keep you supported throughout the whole experience. But we'll start finding a comfortable place to sit or lie down. We're just gonna connect our body and our breath and quiet our mind. So find that comfortable position today. Go ahead and close your eyes. Get settled into your body. And just take a few natural breaths here. Listening to the sound of your breath going in and out, much like the ocean. I'm going to go ahead and ring the singing bowl, and each time you hear the singing bowl, take a slow, deep breath in through your nose and out through your mouth. Here we go. Once more. Keeping your eyes closed, I'll go ahead and sing the singing bowl to hear that sound. And when you no longer hear that sound, you can slowly open your eyes and come back to the room. Breathing in all light, love, and healing energy. And breathing out anything that no longer serves you. Welcome to your body. We're gonna go ahead and slowly warm up our bodies. When we get into our full restorative practice, we'll actually only do a few poses and hold them for a few minutes at a time. But we're gonna go ahead and move our body just to kind of wake everything up and get everything prepared for our stillness and our rest. You may want blankets or bolsters or blocks, or you can really use items from home. You can use books, pillows, or even a chair on a wall. And we'll go through that as we get to each of our poses. But let's go ahead and find our way on to our back. That's where we're gonna start today. And we're just gonna warm up our bodies here. So find a comfortable spot on your back. And we're gonna go ahead, if it feels okay in your body, we're gonna lift up our legs so they're floating off the ground. And we're gonna take our arms up, elbows resting on the floor. And we're just gonna go ahead and roll out our wrists and ankles in the same direction a few times, waking up all those joints, feeling each movement going nice and slow. Breathing in through your nose and out through your mouth. Breathing like that throughout the practice. And when you breathe out, just letting go of anything that doesn't serve you. And go the other way. Really connecting our breath and our movement, moving nice and slow. We'll go ahead and tilt our wrists and ankles forward and back, pointing, flex. A couple breaths here. And then side to side, really awakening each motion that our joints can make. Then we'll go ahead and extend our fingers and our toes, stretching them out as big and as wide as they can, and then closing them nice and tight like you're squeezing some lemons. Opening them nice and big and squeezing them tight. Once more. Now we'll go ahead and take our hands and we'll glue them to our knees. And we're going to move with our breath here, gluing our fingers here. Our legs are nice and relaxed. And when we take a breath in, we're going to push with our hands, pushing our knees away from us. And when we breathe in, we're gonna pull our knees back in. So the motion is all happening in our arms and our legs are resting, moving in and out with our breath. So breathe in to push away. And breathe out to pull back in. Nice and gentle. Breathing in. And if we do anything that doesn't fit right in your body, or you can't reach something, or maybe it's not accessible today, find a way that you can just connect with your breath and almost visualize the movement in your mind. Our mind is a very powerful tool. And even if we can't physically do something, if we can visualize it, a lot of the same impacts reach our body. Once more. We're gonna continue with the same breathing in and out and connecting our movement with our breath, but this time we're gonna move our legs and our arms up and then down. So when we breathe in, we're lifting up our legs. They don't need to go to the sky, just wherever feels good for you today. And then breathing out to bring them back down. Breathing in, lifting our limbs up. Exhale, bringing them back down. Once more. We're gonna slowly transition to coming up. So slowly roll over to one side and just take a moment of stillness and breath. We always wanna give our body a chance to prepare for a transition so that it has time to catch up and we aren't rushing from one thing to the next. When you're ready, find your way up, slowly coming up, and we're actually going to transition onto our hands and knees and do a little bit of movement there. If you need some extra padding, you can put a blanket underneath your knees, or even lay a blanket or towel all the way out wherever you're practicing today. Or if you're on carpet, you might not need it at all. But we'll go ahead and start on our hands and knees. We're gonna take a breath in, looking forward, letting our belly slowly fall down towards the ground. And when we exhale, we're gonna send our hips back towards our heels, pushing with our hands, sending our hips down towards the mat. And we can slowly look down towards our belly button, creating a curve at our back. We're gonna take a breath in to come back up. Looking forward, letting our belly fall, and exhale, sending our hips back to our heels, looking down at our belly button. Once more. And out. Nice. Now come to a spot where you can sit for a moment, and we're just gonna go ahead and play with an affirmation. An affirmation is something that you say over and over again, sort of like a mantra, until it becomes a part of who you truly are. And today the affirmation that we're gonna play with during our practice is, I am at peace. Even though the world can be loud or busy or crazy or feel like it's out of our control, we have the ability to create peace in our body and in our mind and in our heart. So we're gonna try to remember that today as we move through our restorative practice. And anytime you start to feel like your mind is racing or you're trying to think about the next thing that's coming after you finish your practice, let's come back to this affirmation and just repeat it in our mind and see if we can find some stillness and peace within. So I like to say an affirmation with a tapping of each finger, creating little mudras, which is yoga for our hands. And I'll say a word for each finger as we tap. So it would go a little something like this. I am at peace. We're gonna say that 3 times, but let's take a big deep breath in before we begin. I am at peace. I am at peace. Once more. I am at peace. Bring one hand to your heart, one hand to your belly, and just take some slow, mindful breaths here on your own. Giving yourself gratitude, thanking your body for being here. Honoring the stillness that we're going to create within. And remember, you can always come back to this affirmation, I am at peace, anytime you need it, during our practice or in life. One more breath. Slowly come back to the room. And we're gonna get ready to move into our restorative poses. Now each pose will hold for about 5 minutes. You are more than welcome to stay there longer or shorter. Remember, whatever feels good in your body is what you need today. Your body is gonna talk to you and tell you what it needs. So let's honor that and make sure that we're listening. You'll need your props at this time. I'm always gonna give you a couple options so that way you can choose where your body would like to be today. I'm gonna use a bolster and a blanket for comfort. I just like blankets because I get a little chilly, so if you know that that's you, you may want one as well. We're gonna move into a supported child's pose. Child's pose is a really nurturing, calming, and soothing thing that you can do on its own. Typically, the pose is an internal posture, so you can go within your body. Much like when we were breathing in and out, going forward and back, your hips are aiming towards your feet. They may not reach there. They may stay up high. That's a-okay. But the pose is typically done with our hips over our heels, hands stretched out, and our forehead down to the ground, wherever you may be on that journey. But for a supported one, it's going to be a little bit more restorative, which is the whole purpose of our practice. You may want to put glasses aside if you're a glasses wearer, or take off anything that may get in your way during your practice if it's weather. But if you have a pillow or a blanket that you're going to roll up, we're actually going to lay on this like a supported little mattress. So you can take your legs wide, you can put a pillow in between your legs. And we're actually just gonna lay our belly and our chest directly on it and using the top part as a pillow to rest your head. If you're using pillows, you may need more than one, or blankets, you may need more than one. And then we'll settle onto it. So I like to have a blanket, just a drape over me. So our knees are wide, we're back on our hips are back on our heels, wherever that may be today. And then we're just gonna lay our belly and our chest over our bolster or our blanket or our pillows and stretch our arms. You can either stretch them out long, or if you want a little bit more of a passive approach, you can even just bring them in, because we're really just opening up our hips and inviting some support there. So find a comfortable spot to lay wherever that is. And if this doesn't resonate, you're always welcome to find another comfortable way to be, because we're just breathing and resting and taking some stillness, possibly running that affirmation through our mind. But we'll just rest and be and breathe here for a few moments. And when I ring the chimes, which are our little bells here, we'll start to come back and come out of this pose, coming back into our body as we transition into the next pose. So take a couple deep breaths here until you find that sweet spot to get settled in. Maybe you just want to curl up in a ball. That works perfect too. Whatever feels good for your body today. Find that sweet spot, close your eyes, and just breathe and be, letting yourself slowly melt onto your mat. start to deepen your breath. Wiggle your fingers, wiggle your toes. Invite a little bit of movement in there. And slowly but gently find your way back up to sitting. Coming out of this supported pose. And just take a moment sitting upright in whatever way feels good. Noticing how your body feels after that gentle supportive rest. We're going to start to transition into our next supported pose, which is Baddha Konasana, or our bound ankle. So this is a really great pose because we're actually connecting our feet together and creating a sort of energy circuit. So all of our energy is transferring from one leg to the other, creating this loop of energy as we rest and breathe and be. So we're going to be laying down for this, but you might want to gather a few things to prop yourself up and offer support. The whole purpose of a restorative practice is it's very passive. We're not using our muscles. We are resting and settling into these poses to get the full benefit. So the props are there truly to help you. So don't ever think of them as hindrance. They're definitely there for the best reasons. There's a couple different ways you can set up for this. You can use blocks, bolster, pillow, blankets. I'm gonna show you all three. So that way you can choose with what you have or what feels right. So we're eventually gonna be lying down on our back, however you wanna get there transition. You're gonna be gluing your feet together to create that little circuit. And then we're gonna let our legs just melt open. Your head will be down, I'm sitting up right now so I can share with you and show you. So you can use your blocks on any angle. I tend to put them at an angle so that my leg can rest in there a little bit more gently. So you're welcome to use your blocks. You are welcome to use a bolster or pillow. This can lie directly under both legs. Your feet are glued together. You are resting open. This may be an option for you, or you can go ahead and roll up your blanket and do the exact same thing that this bolster is doing. Rest your blanket underneath it. You can tuck your blocks underneath it. You can stack up as high, however you need. Maybe your legs are gonna be like this and you're supported. Resting pose, and that's fine. Wherever you are today is beautiful and perfect, and that's where your body needs to be. So I'm gonna go ahead and use the bolster today. You can grab your blanket, get nice and cozy. We'll be here for another 5 minutes. So find what position feels right for you. We'll get settled in there. Remember, you can always come back to your affirmation when you're trying to quiet your mind, find stillness. I have an eye pillow that I like to use. You can use a tissue or a cloth. You don't need anything at all, but I think it's a nice additional tool to help quiet your mind and your take a few minutes to settle here, and we'll rest in this full restorative pose for another 5 minutes. And when we hear the Ting Sha bells, we'll come back into our body and prepare ourselves to transition. Start to wiggle your toes and your fingers. Deepen your breath. Slowly come back into your body. And carefully, in your own time, bring your legs together. And slowly roll over to one side. Taking a couple breaths, nice and gentle and slow, before meeting us all back up. When you're ready, you can come sit back up so we can prepare for our next restorative pose. So you have a couple options for this next position. You're welcome to use blocks and a bolster. A chair would be great. Or you can even use the wall. So we're doing a bit of Stonehenge, or legs up the wall, for those that are familiar with restorative poses. And the setup will look a little something like this if you're going to go ahead and use blocks and a bolster. So you'll set them maybe about a block distance apart. And then we're going to actually lay our bolster quite on top of it, creating our own little yoga Stonehenge. And your legs are actually going to swing up on top of this. So our knees and our feet will actually be above our hips and our heart, just kind of changing gravity a little bit and allowing things to flow a little differently. This is a great option. Another great option is you can throw your legs up gently over a couch or a chair or a side of a bed, some pillows. Or you're welcome, if you're familiar with this posture or this practice, you're welcome to throw your legs up the wall. I'm going to show you how to do that if that's something you'd like to try. And you're always welcome to try something and come out of it if it doesn't feel right, or maybe your body decides it doesn't want to do that today. So you'll scoot yourself fairly close up to the wall. I need a little bit more space for my body, but typically your hips are very close to the wall. You'll slowly bring yourself down, and then you'll just start to shift and walk your legs and hip over to the wall nice and slow, and then allow your legs to just float up. They may not be straight, they may be bent, they may be completely bent with the pads of your feet on the wall, wherever feels nice for your body today, you can choose. So those are some options for this posture. So find what is gonna be the best option for you. I'm gonna go with our classic Stonehenge here. Set my blocks off. And once again, we're just gonna release our tension, release our muscles, and just allow the props to hold us up and allow us to rest there as we release into these poses. Again, we'll be here for about 5 minutes, and you're always invited to come out or stay longer. This is your practice. You are your own yoga teacher. You know what feels good. So just listen and go ahead. You can use a blanket to cover up if you'd like. You could cold like me, use your eye pillow, whatever feels good today. And then we'll slowly get into that new posture, inviting our body to find stillness there. Take a couple deep breaths just to notice the change in shape that our body has made until you start to breathe gently and slowly in a more natural rhythm.
Once again, wiggle your toes and fingers. Bring some gentle movement, maybe ankle rolls, wrist rolls. Coming back into your body. Slowly bring your knees in, whether you're on the wall or have them up on a chair or bolster. Then slowly and carefully begin to roll over to one side. Taking a few moments of stillness and pause to allow your body to regulate after that little inversion. And when you're ready, you can slowly push your way up or find your way up to seated. So we can transition to our last restorative pose for this practice. You'll notice that many of these poses are much like just resting in your bed. Restorative yoga is often compared to adult nap time, which who doesn't need a supportive nap? Sometimes we just need a reminder that that's what we need. So this last pose that we're coming into, if you've practiced yoga before, you may be familiar with Savasana, which is our relaxation rest final pose. We allow our body to fully integrate all the restorative postures that we did in this final pose of stillness. And we can keep inviting back that affirmation of I am at peace, inviting peace within. So you're actually just gonna lay flat out on your mat or wherever you're practicing. And you are welcome to use a bolster under your legs, under your knees, or you can roll up a blanket, allow it to be as wide as possible, or a towel, and then you can slowly roll it up, slide that under your knees. And that's just because it's nice to have a little lift under our knees so that our legs aren't so flat and arching our back. So find what supportive prop you'd like to use or supportive tool. I'm gonna go ahead and use a bolster. We'll get down onto our backs and we'll just slide that underneath our knees if that feels good to you. We're gonna stretch our feet. I'm gonna scoot up a little bit to the corners of our mat. Get our blanket if we'd like it. I'm actually gonna fold mine a nice added weight. If you have a beanbag or a weighted blanket, I like to fold up a blanket in a square. Sometimes place it right over my hips, just giving a little bit of stability and grounding, making me feel a little bit more connected to the earth. So that's a nice option if that's something that you'd like to experiment with. But we'll go ahead and get settled into our final restorative pose. Take a few breaths to regulate in this new position. Arms are just out to the side. We'll go ahead and put our palms down today, connecting down, touching the earth, breathing in and out. And just find your natural rhythm of your breath in this final pose, this final offering unto your body to find peace within.
start to deepen your breath. Wiggle your toes, wiggle your fingers. Invite a little bit of movement back in. Bending your knees. Slowly rocking to one side. Finding a little bit of stillness here. Breathing in and out. Before we make one more transition. When you're ready, you can come up to a seated position. Whatever feels good for your body today. Sitting up nice and tall. Imagining a string pulling you up high to the sky. And go ahead and take our hand to our belly, into our heart. Closing with a connection of our breath once more in the singing bowl. And close our eyes. Recentering back in our body after all that movement and stillness and breath work. Bringing it all back together. Remembering our affirmation, I am at peace, and remembering what we cultivated inside. Each time we hear the singing bowl, we'll take a big deep breath in through our nose and out through our mouth, bringing us back to our body and breath once more before we close out our practice. Keeping our eyes closed as I sing the singing bowl and inviting them open once we no longer hear the sound. And bring our hands to our heart. A big deep breath in. And at the end of yoga, we bow and say namaste, which means the light and love in me bows to the light and love in you. Even though we look different, even though we like different things, we all want love and respect, and we deserve that. So big deep breath in. We bow and say namaste. Thank you so much for taking the time and energy to honor your body today. Please take this peace, take this gentleness with you wherever you go, and I invite you to come back to this practice whenever you think you need it. Thank you so much, and I hope you have a wonderful day.